Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 5.51 that is taken from chapter number 5, Analysis and Design of Beam for Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by Baer and Johnson, 6th edition. So statement is determine the equation of shear and bending moment curve for the beam and loading shown, and in part B, the maximum absolute value of bending moment in the beam. So you can see this is a simply supported beam AB having pin support at point A, and at point B we have a roller support, and there is a triangular load, or you can say linearly varying load, of W is equal to W naught X over L, where W is a function of L, and you can see this is the direction of X. So wherever you want to find this W, so again that will be X, and at that point you can find this W, clear? And this W naught will be here. I will show you how. For example, if you are going to take it over here, so this is your X, clear? And here you have magnitude W, and you are going to find this W. So by using two similar triangle, one is this one and another one is this one, you can take the ratio of their side, that will be equal. So if I take W naught over L, that will be equal to W divided by X. So from here you will get this W will be equal to W naught X by L, which is the same. You can see this equation is same that we have derived here. Okay, now we have this W. So we know that this change of shear force with respect to X is equal to minus W. dV over dx is minus W. You know this equation very well. Okay, because this distributed load is 1 degree less than the shear force, or you can say the shear force will be 1 degree higher than this W. So this is the equation. So put the value of W in this equation, so that will be equal to minus W naught X by L. So you will have this equation, dV over dx is equal to minus W naught X over L. So from here you will get this dV is equal to minus W naught X by L into dx. Now integrate it on both sides. So you will get integral of dV is equal to integral of minus W naught X over L into dx. So integral of dV will give you the shear force, and that shear force will be equal to minus W naught over L, and integral of X into dx, which will give us minus W naught by L plus X square over 2, X square over 2, sorry, this is not plus, this is multiplied, because integral is multiplied, X over 2 plus C1, which is constant of integration. So from here you will get this shear force is equal to minus W naught X square over 2L plus C1. So this is your equation number 1. Again, we know that this V is also equal to dm, change of bending moment with respect to X. This shear force equal to change of rate of change of bending moment with respect to X, because shear force is 1 degree less than the bending moment. So from here you can see dm will be equal to V into dx. So put the value of V, which is minus W naught X square over 2L plus C1 into dx. That will be dm. So if you integrate it on both sides, so integral of dm is equal to integral of minus W naught X square over 2L plus C1 into dx. And this integral of dm will give you bending moment, and that will be equal to minus w naught x square over 2l plus integral of c1 into dx, plus there is also a constant of integration c2. So from here we will get minus w naught x cube over 6l plus c1 into x n plus c2. And this is the bending moment equation, and this equation is known as equation number 2. So you can see that both these equations having c1 and c2, they are unknown constant of integration. So c1 and c2 are unknown constant of integration, and we can find them using boundary condition. C1 and C2. How we'll find them? So you can see that the first boundary condition is that at x is equal to 0, you have moment is equal to 0. Let me show you here. You can see you have at x is equal to 0, because this is a pin support. So at x is equal to 0, here moment will be equal to 0. So you will put it in equation number 2. Put in equation number 2. So, put in equation number 2. Okay, this is equation number 2. So, when you put x is equal to 0 in this equation, so this will be 0 and this will be equal to 0, and moment is already 0. Clear? So, it means that C2 is equal to 0. So, I will write C2 is equal to 0. Now, what we will do is that we will use the second boundary condition, and second boundary condition is that at x is equal to L, you have moment is again 0. And you can see at point B, you have roller support, and at this point, x is equal to L, so moment will be also equal to 0. So again, we will put in equation number 2. So it will be equal to m will be 0 minus w naught l cube over 6l plus c1 into l, and c2 is 0. So from here c1 into l will be equal to w naught l square over 6. So from this we will get c1 will be equal to w naught l by 6. Okay, so this is the value of c1 and c2. Okay, put the value of c1 in equation number 1. So which is the equation number 1? This is your equation number 1, which is minus w naught. So I will write it here, v is equal to minus w naught x square over 2l plus c1, which is w naught l by 6. Clear? And if you take this w naught common from this, w naught over 6 common from this, so you, what you will get is that w naught x square over 2l plus c1 is w naught l square over 6. So if you take this w naught, okay, let me simplify it further. So if you take the LCM, so it will be 6, let me show you, 6 and 2. 2 3s are 6, 1. So it will be 3, 1. So it will be 6L. Now 6L divided by 2L is 3, so 3 multiplied by minus W naught X square plus 6L divided by 6 will give you L, so it will be W naught L square. Okay, so further simplifying it, V will be equal to minus 3 W naught X square plus W naught L square over 6L. And if you take this W naught L square common from this, divide by 6L. So it will be minus 3x square plus L square. Sorry, what I have, take only W naught over 6L. Okay, wait. 3 W naught. Okay, what I am making a mistake somewhere. So if you take this 6L and W naught common, so it will be W 3 minus 3x square plus L square. Okay, L square. And from this you will get V is equal to W naught over 6L into L square minus 3x square. And this is your equation number 3, which is the required shear force equation. Now for bending moment equation, put C1 and C2 in equation number 2. So this is your equation number 2. Okay, this is your equation number 2. So after putting that, you will get M will be equal to minus W naught X cube over 6L plus C1, which is W naught L over 6 into X, and C2 is equal to 0. So from here, you will get this equation, moment equation. And if again you take the LCM, so this moment will be equal to 6L, so minus W naught X cube plus W naught L square X. And from here we will take W naught over 6L common from that. So what we will get is minus X cube plus L square into X. Okay. So further simplifying it, this moment will be equal to, if L is divided multiplied to this inner two portions, so we will get W naught over 6 into minus X cube over L plus L square over L into X, and that will give us the moment is equal to W naught over 6 times L X minus X cube over L. And this is equation number 4. Now equation 3 and 4 are required. This is required shear force equation for the loading shown, and this is required bending moment equation for the loading shown. Now in part B, we have been asked to find the maximum absolute value of bending moment. So we know that maximum bending moment occurs where shear force is equal to 0. So put V is equal to 0 in equation number 3. What is equation number 3? Let me show you. This is your equation number 3. So if you put V is equal to 0, so this will be equal to 0 is equal to W naught over 6L. 0 is equal to W naught over 6L into L square minus 3x. L square minus 3x. So from here, what we will get is 0 is equal to W naught L square W naught L square minus 3x. Because when you multiply 6L on both sides, so 6L multiply by 6L, this will give you 0 and it will cancel with this. So from here we will get 3x is equal to W naught L square, and we need X, the location where shear force is equal to 0. So it will be W naught L square over 3. Okay. I think, let me check it. Okay, this is, you can see by moving here, I made a mistake. This is square. So I will make it square. It will be square. So 3x square, and this is also square. So if you find x, so x will be equal to, and one more thing is that again, this W naught will be multiplied with this and with this. Here, W naught. Okay, so here I also have W naught. So W naught will cancel. So what I have to make this, it will be equal to x square is equal to L square over 3. And if you take square root on both sides, so it will be L square over 3, which will give you L by under root 3. X is equal to L over under root 3. Now this is the value of x for which the shear force will be zero and bending moment will be maximum. So put x is equal to L by under root 3 in equation number 4. Equation number 4 is this one. This is your equation number 4. So let me write it. This is 1 over 6 W naught into Lx minus x cube over L. So I will write it, moment is equal to 1 over 6 times W naught into Lx minus x cube over L. So just plug in the value of this x in this. So when you put it, it will give you maximum bending moment. So it will be equal to 1 over 6 W naught into L multiplied by L over under root 3 minus L over under root 3 whole cube divided by L. Okay. Yes. So what we will get is that 1 over 6 W naught, and it will be L square over under root 3, and that will be equal to minus this L and L. Here it is 1. So it will be L cube over cube whole cube divided by L. So simplifying it, this L will cancel with one of this. So it will be L square over under root 3 minus L square over under root 3 whole cube. 1 over 6 W naught. Okay, that is maximum bending moment. And further, if you simplify this, you take 1 over under root 3 and multiply it with L square, then minus 1 over under root 3 power 3. So that will give you, and divided by 6, so it will give you 0.0642 W naught L square, which is the maximum bending moment. And that is the answer of our second part. So this was all about this problem 5.51. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.